Hey guys, it's Sibo here. Today I'm going to break down my top 10 Warzone tips, so let's get straight into it. Number 1, be the aggressor. Defending most positions on the map is very difficult. In general, the offensive team has the advantage. They can choose where to attack from and when to attack. You might be able to make it to the last 10 and give yourself a nice little pat on the back by just hiding all game, but you'll be under-equipped and your plan will just involve hoping nobody can find you. If you want to win games, you need to be comfortable hunting down enemies so they can't hunt you down later. Tip number 2, get money and spend money. Money is vital in this game. Doing objectives, getting kills and moving around the map a lot will help you and your team earn more cash. In a typical game, you probably want 2 loadout boxes, a few UAVs, a couple of self-revives, armor satchels, a gas mask if you haven't already found one, and on top of this, you might be looking for armor crates and munition boxes. So as you can see, there is a lot to spend money on in Warzone. Often games are lost that could have been won because you didn't have a UAV or self-revive when you most needed it. In general, every game you want to do as much as you possibly can to earn money, and don't be scared to use it either. There's no point holding onto $10,000 or holding onto a cluster strike all game because you're waiting for the best moment to use it. Money should be very abundant in Warzone, and if it is not, then you are probably playing the game wrong. Tip number 3, avoid long vehicle journeys. Sadly for you drivers out there, C4s exist in this game and they are in almost everybody's loadouts. And the longer you drive a vehicle for, the greater your chances of going boom boom and just getting team wiped. If you're taking a vehicle, try not to go through areas of the map where sightlines are restricted and someone could just jump out of nowhere and get the entire team kill with absolutely no effort whatsoever. Also, try not to drive with your entire team in one vehicle. This way, if one vehicle gets squished, it's not an automatic team wipe and the rest of the team can come to help. If you want to travel somewhere by a vehicle, helicopters are better than cars, but if you are driving a helicopter, have an escape plan. If your heli gets ripped apart into 1,000 pieces, then you want your entire team to land somewhere safe and together. You don't want to be in a situation where everyone is 200 meters apart from each other and then the team that blew you down just runs down each of your teammates separately. In general, you have a much better control over not dying if you use vehicles less. Tip number 4, take advantageous fights. If you have the opportunity to take a 2v1 or 4v3, then take it. It will avoid the enemies hunting you down later and them taking the numbers advantage. It will not only make the area that you are in safer, it will also give you precious resources for late game. Similarly, if the enemy doesn't know where you are, the enemy has worse guns, you are in a better position, the enemy is running in from the gas, or the enemy has no armor, are all signs that you probably want to go on the offensive. The opposite is also true. Unless you are mechanically a god at this game, you don't want to be taking fights when you have no armor, you don't have the numbers advantage, or any scenario where you have a low chance of success. This game is as much about when to fight as it is how you fight. Tip number 5, make the most use out of contracts that you can. Not only are contracts a great way to get resources in Warzone, they also come with great benefits, especially recon. It is a great way of finding out where the circle is going to be, which will give you the ability to plan ahead to the later stages of the game. Also make great use out of bounty contracts. Not only does it allow you to hunt down a team fairly easily, but it's great to be used defensively as well. It's very hard for an enemy team to attack you if you know roughly where they are at all times. Obviously, Most Wanted is a very dangerous contract to pick up, but it can be game-changing if you're the last one left on your team, just jump in a helicopter, fly around, and everyone can come back. Tip number 6, play close to your teammates. If you are teaming up, then playing close to your teammates is a must in Warzone. As I mentioned previously, you want to do everything you can to take advantageous fights. and splitting up instantly puts yourself at a disadvantage against 90% of all the other teams on the map. You don't have to play on top of each other. In fact, it's much better to play slightly separated so you can get an angle when attacking an enemy. But you should be close enough that if your friends come under fire, then you are able to rescue them within seconds. Tip number 7, ping everything. Communication is key in Warzone. Knowing where the enemies are, knowing where vehicles or guns you are interested in are, or knowing where you are heading is a must. You must be pinging the following: where enemies are on the map, whether it's from a UAV or from seeing them, where you are planning on moving to, whether this is a general vicinity or whether it's a specific building, where contracts or vehicles that you are interested in are. A ping is worth 1,000 words, it is quick and precise, you cannot use them enough. Tip number 8, plan ahead. If you only plan what you are doing next, then chances are you will end up in a god awful position. You should be planning all the way up to endgame to make sure that when you are in the last 5 or 10 teams, you have the advantage against all of them. Not only do you need to get to the endgame with your loadout, ghost perk, self-revives, UAV, all of your teammates alive and with full armor, but you also need to have an advantageous position, whether that's the high ground, a strongly holdable building, or some juicy cover. And this requires a bit of planning beforehand. Recon missions, as I mentioned earlier, are a great way of finding out where the circle is landing, so you use them to their fullest. My penultimate tip is pick a good loadout. There are a lot of guys out there telling you what guns are meta and what's not, but picking guns that suit your style of play and leveling them up to a decent level are a must in Warzone. Just because a streamer you follow told you that the Kilo is the best gun in the game, or because your friend told you that a specific sniper rifle setup was OP, doesn't mean that you have to follow suit. But spending a bit of time adjusting your gun to suit what you need it for and your playstyle will go a long way. Having said this, there are some aspects of a loadout that are just a hands down must. First up, we have perks. Okay, so there are some definite perks that you want, including cold-blooded. It is much better than any other tier 1 perk, so just go with that on all of your loadouts. If you want two primary weapons and your playstyle will let you have enough money for a second loadout, then go for an overkill class first and then a ghost class second. You don't really want any other perk other than ghost or overkill on any loadout for your second perk. Tier 3 perks suck. I usually go with Tracker, but Amp is also not bad, but it matters less than your first two perks. Next up, let's talk about your gun choice. Choose the right gun for the situation that you plan to be in. SMGs and shotguns are the best for close range. Assault rifles and LMGs are good for medium range, and sniper rifles and rifles are best for long range. We have all had moments where we mow down an enemy team with a shotgun and they can be really efficient at taking people down, but their use is very limited. Usually I go with an assault rifle and a sniper rifle if the area of the map I'm planning to go with has long sightlines, and assault rifle slash SMG if I'm in a closed area. There's no point in getting a sniper rifle if you're going door to door, and SMG is a lot better. Having said this, I tend to keep my primary gun, my assault rifle, consistent. Personally, I like the consistency of it, meaning that I don't have to get used to too many different guns between games. And last but not least, tip number 10, train your mechanics. Learning the spray of your loadout gun, the fall off of sniper rifles, and practicing locking onto the heads of targets as quickly as possible will help you tremendously. You can always try things like Aim Labs, Osu, or custom games to try and improve your aim, but if none of that is your jam, then Plunder is always a good mode for getting better mechanics. So that is it, that is my top 10 tips for Warzone. If you have any others, then please just chuck them in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching my videos, I really appreciate every single one of you. Usually I do videos on Overwatch, so if you enjoy Overwatch related videos, then check out the rest of my channel. But I will see you next time.